Welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on light sensing. My name is Roland Gordon, and I am an applications engineer for Texas Instruments Optical Sensors. This video will introduce and cover a few of the basics around color and color sensors. The fundamentals of light sensing chapter in this video series discussed how the human eye sees light and the corresponding wavelengths that make up the visible spectrum. However, the human eye not only differentiates light based on brightness, but also color. Of the two different types of photoreceptors, called rods and cones, rods are typically used in low light conditions and only can sense the brightness of light. Cones are typically used in well-lit conditions and sense both brightness and color. Cones can also be divided into long, medium, and short, or L, M, and S cones. Each cone name refers to the relative wavelength that each cone is sensitive to within the visible spectrum. The combination of how light excites each cone type and the relative number of each type gives us both our color vision and our photopic brightness response in well-lit conditions. Also discussed in the Fundamentals of Light Sensing chapter was electromagnetic waves and their lengths. It stated that the visible light wavelengths are from 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers. Here, you can see the visible colors and their corresponding ranges of wavelengths. White light is a mixture of all the colors in the entire visible spectrum, and black is a total absence of light. There are two processes in which color is created, subtractive and additive. The subtractive color process is done by absorbing particle wavelengths which are subtracted from the full spectrum of visible light or white light. The wavelengths that are reflected back off the surface make up the color that people see. This is a process done in everyday viewing of our surroundings. For example, if white light from the sun falls on a green surface such as grass, a person will see green. However, if a red light source illuminated the green grass, a person would see black. The additive color process is when narrow bands of visible light are added together to produce a light that is a different color. This is commonly used by light sources that produce colored light. Displays and monitors use the primary colors red, green, and blue in the additive process to produce white light and all the other colors. Color temperature, measured in degrees Kelvin, is the perceived color of light that is radiated from an object. All objects above absolute zero emit light or electrometric radiation that is called black body radiation or Planckian radiation. Objects around room temperature emit light mostly in the deep infrared spectrum, thus emitting no visible light. Starting around 1000 Kelvin, objects will start to resemble a dim, deep red while most of the light is still in the infrared. Around 1500 Kelvin, objects will start to emit significant amounts of visible light, and as the color temperature changes, so will the perceived color of the light. At 1500 Kelvin, the light will appear more red. From 5000 Kelvin to 7000 Kelvin, the light will appear as white. At about 8000 Kelvin, the light will appear more blue. Although light appearing more red has a lower color temperature, the type of light is referred to as a warm color. The reciprocal is also true, that a light with a high color temperature value is referred to as a cool color. For light sources that don't produce light from a heated element, their color temperature can be characterized as correlated color temperature, or CCT, which is also measured in Kelvin. For the purposes of light sensors, CCT is what is referenced when it comes to how warm, cool, or neutral a light appears. The trichromatic color theory indicates that we receive three types of color, red, green, and blue, and that the ratio of each color determines the color we see. Based on this, the International Commission on Illumination, or CIE, created three-dimensional maps called color spaces that describes the colors that can be created combining three light sources. In an RGB color space, the color is set by the ratio of each dimension's value. However, it was found that no combination of any three real light sources could create a color space that captures all perceivable colors. To solve this problem, the CIE 1931 XYZ color space was created that describes all colors. With this standard, everyday colors can be represented universally. For example, the Federal Highway Administration defined the size and shape of the color areas in the CIE XYZ color space, used to specify colors for traffic control signs and lights. The color box shown represents the colors that can be used for red and traffic lights. Also with the XYZ color space, brightness is simply a function of the Y channel, with Y being linear to lux. In addition, with finding the unit vector of X and Y, color can be described with only two dimensions, lowercase x and lowercase y, thus enabling the color space to be printed. With the data from a color sensor, as well as the brightness data, display brightness and color performance can be altered. This, in turn, enhances the user viewing experience so that any display is easy to see and correctly projects any image in all lighting conditions. A color sensor can also improve white balancing and image correction for cameras and video recorders, as well as enabling color matching. With color sensors like TI's OPT4060 and OPT4048, all applications with displays can be improved. In the rest of this chapter, we will go into more detail about color sensors, their uses, considerations, integrations, and more. For more light sensor technical resources and to search TI products, please visit the link shown. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Please try the following quiz. What does correlated color temperature, or CCT, represent? CCT represents how warm or cool a light source appears. Does the CIE 1931 XYZ color space represent all perceivable colors? Yes, the CIE 1931 XYZ color space was created so that all colors can be described.